Welcome back to Bred to Win. As a Golden Slipper winner, naturally, there was plenty of hype around the retirement of Vancouver, and his first foals are already living up to their star billing. Sebastian, we talk about the very best of horses of their generation, and the Golden Slipper winner generally is that Vancouver, no exception. And wow, just blown away by how he looks here in his second season at Coolmore.
He was an awesome racehorse. He retired a stud with essentially impeccable credentials as a young stallion. The precedent of Slipper winners retiring to stud is awesome. You know, each of the last 10 with a full three-year-old crop to race have sired Group 1 winners. So it's a fait accompli that the Golden Slipper winning colt will go on to be a good stallion. It helps that he's obviously an incredibly good-looking specimen by a world-class stallion with a beautiful pedigree. So he's the real deal, the complete package, whatever way you want to surmise him.
Berra Miller, she's a mare by Fastnet Rock. She won 6 races. And you know, again, we start off with just a beautiful foal as the first foal to show.
Oh, look, horses like Vancouver attract the very best mares in their first crop. It stands to reason that they would. Berra Miller was a very talented race mare by Fastnet Rock out of a tail the cat mare, very attractive aesthetically. This is a fantastic maiden foal, very much in the image of the stallion. Similar head, similar shape, nice short back on him, good short cannons, plenty of scope, big hip. He's very racy looking, and you know, he's a really good endorsement of the stallion, particularly as a first foal.
Well, Took, okay, Giant's Causeway is the sire of Took, this mare. So it's a really interesting pedigree matchup with obviously Vancouver coming through the El Prado sprinting side of the Sadler's Wells line, which has done so well in America.
Oh, Giant's Causeway is an outstanding sire of sires, so it's a great feather in the cap of the book of Vancouver that he can get mares like Took into the book. This is an outstanding filly, you know, really beautiful, incredible strength. She's very mature and forward-looking, moves with great purpose, you know, very bold, forward-going outlook, lovely quality, great head, again, good clean limbs, really, really likeable foal in terms of temperament. The mare is a bit buzzy herself, but this foal is of great demeanour. And, you know, it's a beautiful pedigree, as you say.
Well, one of your great pedigrees you've done so well at Coolmore through is the Prawn Cocktail pedigree. Of course, the Royal Academy Stormcat family. And Sevruga, now she's an Encosta de Largo mare. So this filly by Vancouver is just a lovely, well-balanced sort of foal. Quite short coupled, though, with that strong back end and shoulder and plenty of speed in this filly.
Yeah, the stallion is well patronised by a number of mares that are owned by the China Horse Club. This is one of those mares. She's a very well-bred mare, as you've said. This is her best foal, definitively. It's got incredible strength, great hip, lovely line of hind leg, good hocks, moves well, you know, very athletic foal. Again, I mean, it sounds like I'm repeating myself, but it's very much what you expect to see of a Vancouver foal. Outstanding quality, lovely colour, like all the aesthetics are right, the angles are all right. There's a horse that you expect to see go to a commercial marketplace and be very, very well received. Look, he was an elite two-year-old. I mean, he was an unbeaten Golden Slipper winning two-year-old. He broke the two-year-old track record at Randwick in the Todman. He ran one of the quickest times for a colt ever winning the Slipper, having drawn barrier 16. So his credentials as a two-year-old were impeccable, or are impeccable. But there's absolutely no doubt looking at him that had he had the fortune to properly express his abilities as a three-year-old, you know, we're talking about a horse that had the ability to go and win Golden Roses, Guineas, Coolmores. Aidan O'Brien trained this horse for a period in Europe and just said he was something frighteningly talented. He could never get him quite right. It was misfortune for the horse that it happened to be the case. And look, as a consequence of things like that, he gets tremendously well patronised at Sud. I mean, 50% of his book were either black type performers or black type producers. That gives him an incredible opportunity. The patronage of the majority of the best breeders in the country means that he got a lot of good mares from a lot of the best people, and it's going to give him a great opportunity, an opportunity that he's earned. And we have great faith in this horse. He's been very well supported again in his second season, primarily on the back of what people are seeing with their first foals. I mean, when you meet people, breeders the caliber of Someone like John Muir at the races, and he tells you the best foal on his farm is a Vancouver foal. It's not hard to get very enthusiastic about a young stallion when you hear things like that. You know, this horse, in much the same way as Piero's demonstrating now, has the credentials to be a sire of very versatile stock. You know, stock like him that were precocious and mature at 2 year olds, but have the physique to progress and the pedigree to progress further as they get older over a variety of trips. And that sort of versatility is an incredible asset in any stallion.